This is a short presentation on ordering radiographs of the knee for the primary care physician. The objective of this presentation is to review the six types of x-rays that can be ordered by the primary care physician. The six common x-ray views of the knee are the AP or anterior posterior view, a weight-bearing AP view, a lateral view, oblique view, a posterior to anterior or PA Rosenberg view, and a mergent view. The AP view is the most basic x-ray view of the knee. The beam runs from the front to the back, and that x-ray shows a distal femur, proximal tibia, and proximal fibula. You can visualize the patella behind or in front of the femur. You can visualize the femoral-tibial joint space, as well as the fibular head and proximal tibia. You can identify fractures and osteoarthritis. Perhaps the most important view is the weight-bearing AP view. This is a view where the patient is standing while an x-ray is taken. You can see here on the left, the knee with the white arrow shows an adequate joint space of the medial compartment as well as lateral compartment. The same x-ray taken where the patient is standing up on the right shows that the space narrows and thus the diagnosis of osteoarthritis nearly bone on bone that would not have been detected in a non-weight-bearing view. The lateral view is a good view to see the patellofemoral joint, distal femur, proximal tibia. You can identify fractures, you can see the contour of each condyle as well as the tibia and the patella. Oblique views of the knee are probably the least useful view. They are taken when there is lateral or medial rotation of the knee. When there is medial rotation, you can see the proximal tibia fibula joint very well. And when there's lateral rotation, you can see the medial compartment well. One of the most important views that can be ordered is the mergent view. It perhaps is the most forgotten view to be ordered because most people order a standard view. The mergent view of the knee is probably the most important view that is the least ordered. It's often forgotten in the standard series because most doctors would just order an AP and a lateral view. However, the mergent view shows the patellofemoral joint very clearly. You can see here on the left that the knee is bent 45 degrees and the beam comes from the top down to really isolate that patellofemoral joint. You can see the patella in profile. This view is excellent to show if there's patella dislocation, patella subluxation, or patellofemoral arthritis. The final view is the PA Rosenberg view. This is an often neglected view because people don't quite understand it. The image on the left shows a patient with their knee bent 45 degrees and the x-ray beam angled down 10 degrees, and this shows the condyles of the knee joint. Here on the x-ray on the right, you can see a standard AP view showing some medial compartment narrowing, and then the Rosenberg view with the right arrow showing the posterior femoral condyle contacting the tibia. The Rosenberg view is very good at looking at the back of the condyles and putting those in contact with the tibia. So when do you order which views? Well, the standard three views are the AP, lateral, and mergent. The standard four views are the AP, lateral, oblique, and mergent. It's very important that the AP view be a weight-bearing view to evaluate for osteoarthritis. This is probably the most common mistake that I see made is a patient coming in with an AP view, non-weight-bearing, and it requires us to retake another x-ray in the weight-bearing view. For osteoarthritis, which is the most common diagnosis in patients over 60, they must have a weight-bearing view. If you want to look at the patellofemoral joint for patella dislocation, for patellofemoral osteoarthritis, or patellofemoral syndrome, you need the mergent view. If you want to look at a cartilage lesion in the condyles, you want the PA Rosenberg view.